your reputation is, the history of your action and response. I remember after people give me the finger and check me. I was telling somebody who hadn't seen me in a while, you think I got a finger and check me, what'd you do? Because they expected the response. I had a reputation of pissing people down. And they were amazed I don't chase them down. But you know what it meant for them? If Mark Shell can conquer something little like that, I bet you I can conquer getting mad at my wife with something ignorant. I'll bet you I can conquer getting upset at my neighbor over something mean. Because see, you're no longer just mad at your neighbor. You are affecting the character of your witness. It's hard to believe somebody that just cussed them out the day before. Abraham Lincoln said this. He said, nearly all men can stand adversity, but if you want to test a man's character, give him power. Isn't that amazing how power changed some people? Isn't it amazing how power changes some people? Church, hear me. You may have been a person that people know you for responding to a finger, if you will, in a negative way. How about let's start changing that reputation? When your grandkids come over and you were telling a story, oh, Papa, did you get mad and come up? Oh, no, baby. I just smiled and said, God bless you. Papa, that's not like you. I know I'm becoming a new creature, a new man in Christ Jesus. Baby, I'm reforming and transforming my character. But you are a character witness of Jesus Christ. You and I are to be living proof the flesh has no dominion over you. Stop excusing anger out of us. Stop excusing. There are no more excuses. The power in the Holy Spirit is in us to help us conquer these things. Well, what do I do when I feel like letting them hit the other one? Man, I'm not the cassette. What are you doing? I'm maintaining my character. I'm just saying, God, I need here. I'm going to see you. I can care less whether they're thinking about it and what I feel about it. I want them to see you because my love for your witness is greater than my need for justification. Just being a witness. Abraham Lincoln also, character is like a, and reputation is like a shadow. The shadow is what we think of it. The trick is the real thing. See, we can all put on a good show. We all have characters, don't we? Especially in a charismatic, spirit-filled, grace-oriented, word of faith. Church, how you doing? Oh, I'm blessed, you and highly favored of God. And how's the family of all? Thank God they're blessed. And you barely get it. And you're yelling at each other. Then when your wife needs something, she has to call the pastor to get it because she doesn't trust your anointing. Your character will change the circumstances. somebody's needing to hear that. You're waiting on somebody to do something to change the way you respond. It ain't gonna happen. You change the way you respond, and it'll change what they do. Are you glad you came tonight? Amen. Remember, all three of these have the blood and the water. Holy Spirit, pray in tongues until that thing goes away. Because as long as you react to it, you grow. You pray in the Spirit. The enemy of that thing can only grow upon your intelligence. When you give him your intelligence, it begins to manifest even greater. But when you pray in the Holy Spirit, you are starving that thing, and it will come to the place because it no longer has a hold on you. Thank you, Lord. It's no longer called a character flaw. It is referred to as an anointing impact. this is at least my label. My actions are lining up with my words. I hope this is helping you, and I hope it's making you. But I have to do this too, because my job is to be a witness. It's your calling to be a witness. Somebody said, I'm becoming bilingual. This is what he was talking about in the spiritual essence of it. He said, this witness of the water, of the life of God, the Word of God in you, your actions. Didn't Jesus say this? If you believe my words, watch my miracles. Because when you walk in integrity, you don't always have to say it. Your actions are louder than your words. Remember, integrity. This is what the Lord gave me. I want to make sure I quote that right. Integrity is the microphone through which a person speaks. So if my actions are not lining up, oh, Pastor, I'm with you and I'm behind you. Where'd he go? Hello? And many people are tempted to do that. Pastor, I'm with you. I've never loved anybody but you. I love you. I love you, sir. Agree with. job. You be the most faithful, personal, and truthful person you can be on your job. And then when your boss or your employee needs something, they know that man is a man of integrity. And if he told me to go back to the doctor again, I believe I'm healed. Then I'm going to do what he says. Your integrity is directly connected to your actions. You can talk a good game, but if your actions don't line up with your words, you are as a sounding brass and a tinkling cymbal. It's what Paul said. I go on dealings. Hello? This is good. Albert Einstein said this: whoever is careless with the truth, in small matters cannot be trusted with important matters. We've got people wanting to run churches that can't even be on time for it. We've got people wanting to run ministries that aren't even faithful with their time. Do you see? It's not a heaven or hell, saved or unsaved issue. It's a witness issue, people. That's what it is. Get beyond the, oh, am I not saying? That's not what I'm talking about. I'm talking about if I can't be trusted with the little thing, Jesus said, how can I trust you with kingdoms? So I must bring myself into subjection and every thought into the obedience of Christ and consider that my word represents who I am. And if I say I'm going to do something or not going to do it, then by God, that's what I'm going to do or not going to do. Amen. Am I trying? No. Well, I just have so much on my plate. Now you see this is a scheme of the enemy, right? To keep so busy, you can't be trusted. George Washington said this: I hope I shall always possess firmness and virtue enough to maintain what I consider the most enviable of all titles, the character of an honest man. Somebody say integrity. Integrity is the microphone through which you speak. Your voice is no louder than your words lining up with your actions. To be beloved. Amen. Edward Murrow said this: to be persuasive, we must be believable. To be believable, we must be credible. Credible, we must be truthful. What are you saying, Mark? You've got to be honest with yourself. Stop making excuses and say, if I say something, I'm going to do it. If I say I'm not going to do it, I'm not going to do it. If I say I'm going to be on time, I'm going to be on time. Because if I any more excuses, I realize when people see my actions not matching my words, they act not believable as a witness. Facilitates the defies their needs. So why? Is this okay? So we establish and reestablish my integrity, because you may have been. I know I did 100 things on the plate, and I wouldn't do what I said, and I really am working on making my actions line up with my words. And I think maybe some of you are like me. The areas we need to line up, amen. So how do we do that? Well, you've got to have a reputation of your purpose. I mean, Saul of Tarsus had a reputation of incarcerating Christians, persecuting, torturing. But because leave this building tonight and say, God, forgive me. I didn't see it like that. Or he'll be in the area. My words and my actions have not been that of a man or a woman of integrity. God, tonight, I commit my life to you all over again. Help me reflect you through my life. I want to change my reputation. Tonight, I'm having a revelation that I am no longer alone. I've been bought with a price, and it's not a choice to live like you. It is a privilege to live like you. Amen. Establish it or reestablish it, I consider the cost of allowing all this to happen. I have to consider the cost of allowing my intentions to outweigh my abilities. How do we get in trouble with our integrity? We commit to more than we can do. No, hear me. God never puts too much on your plate that's going to affect your punctuality. That's the enemy. To affect your integrity. So I hope that's helping you. Mark, you know, I reestablish this reputation of being a person of integrity so that my microphone becomes more clear in the hearer's ear. Consider each time an obligation arises, I have to consider, am I going to be good at this one thing, or am I going to screw up 50 things trying to please everybody? How do I establish it? Hey, we're being challenged tonight, amen? We're being challenged. Whether you never put on another Grace Fellowship t-shirt, I love Jesus and he loved me so much, he slapped his arms on me. Whether you ever wear another Christian t-shirt or a Christian necklace or whatever bumper sticker, let the world see your integrity. Somebody say all three. See, I hope we're improving on our believability by working in these things. But he said the spirit, the water, and the blood. Somebody say the blood. Or what? How do I say this? I have to establish. We hear a lot about honor in our circle of churches, but let's see another side of honor. Honor is not a gift you give yourself. Honor is a gift bestowed upon you by the men you serve. Honor is not a gift given to you by yourself. It's a gift given to you by the people you serve. If you're not honored by people, it's because you don't serve them more than likely. Mark, I serve them and they don't honor me. Then God will send someone else to plant a seed in them. Don't let it affect your character. It's simply a respect of position. You build Jesus say something like that? He said, I didn't come to be served. I came to serve. I didn't come to honor me. I came to honor you before my Father. When we get that mentality as witness, I'm not here just to tell people about Jesus. I'm here to serve people like Jesus. Then men are going to honor me. And remember, I have to go back in the notes to see it. I just wrote it today. Reputation of honor is the arena in which the audience will gather. If I have audience to hear and believe my witness, it's because I have not served them to honor. There is no honor, there is no witness. Shakespeare said this, my honor is my life. Both grow in one. Take honor from me, and my life is done. My question is, who have you been serving? And have you been serving them to get something from them? Or have you been serving them selflessly to reveal the witness of the Christ? Martin Luther King Jr. said this, the first question which the priest and the Levite asked was, if I stop to help this man, the man in the ditch, what will happen to me? But the Good Samaritan reversed the question, if I do not stop to help this man, what will happen to him? See, this is one of the issues I have, and you know my heart, so don't take it in any other light of what I'm about to say, if I can say it the way I intend to. I'm all for the word of faith, but some people got a hold of it and made it a selfish gospel. It's what I can get out of it. But it's not what you can get. It's about what you can give to people. Amen. He reversed the question and said, if I don't stop and help this man, what's going to happen to him? See, when you truly become a witness, it's not about what's going to happen to me if I start helping this person. It's about what's going to happen to them if I stop. George Bush said this, from now on, any definition of a successful life must include serving others. If you want to be honored, serve. Mother Teresa, I love this book. Mother Teresa is love. And love in action is service. Try to give unconditionally whatever a person needs in the moment. The point is to do something, however small, and show you care through your actions by giving your time. We are all God's children, so it's important to share His gifts. Do not worry about why problems exist in the world. Just respond to the people's needs. We feel what we are doing is just a drop in the ocean, but that ocean would be less without that drop. Even the slightest bit of service. Mow your neighbor's grass. And you see what I'm saying? Something to serve. It's not all done in here. It's out here. That's where the wells are, out there. Go meet the people at the wells out there. Galatians 13th verse. Talking about honor and the reputation of honor. The word, for you were called to freedom, brothers. Only don't use your freedom as an opportunity for the flesh, but through love, serve one another. Do you see? If I understand grace, I'm a servant. I'm a friend of God, but I'm a servant to men. Jesus said, if you do what I tell you to do, I'm going to call you servant, but I call you friend. My relationship with God as I'm a friend of God, but to you, I'm a servant. I am here to help fulfill any need you have. I'm selflessly. And I no longer fear what will happen. I fear what will happen to you if I don't. One of the principal rules of Christianity, John Wesley said this, and I have 2 minutes and I'll quit. Somebody say it with me. I'm improving my believability. John Wesley said one of the principal rules of Christianity is to lose no occasion of serving God. When I serve you, I serve God. And since He is invisible to our eyes, we are to serve Him in our neighbor, which He receives as if done to Himself in person, standing visibly before us. When you serve a person, you're serving God. When you serve, they see God. How do I establish this honor? Somebody say, serve. The degree that I serve them is the exact value I place on them. I only serve men to the degree I value them. Now, soak that. Because anybody can renovate their kindness. But when you truly serve them, you not only get them out of the ditch, you pour in the oil and the wine, and you clothe them. And you bring them to a mentality of safety. I only serve, though, to the degree I value them. It's given when the bridegroom, this is, if I did not, honor is given when the price you is greater than the dreams you carry. You will be honored by men when you serve them, even when you could have taken time to fulfill your dreams. Jesus said, no greater love is a man than he would lay down his life. What is serving God? Laying down your life to show Jesus to somebody else. To build honor, we must lay down our life for someone. What would you say? Give up a part of your life to serve someone. Do you realize why this church has so many branches of ministry? They're giving you opportunity to become believable. If I'm too busy for the church, I'm too busy to be the anointed one somebody may need. Still love me? How do I establish this honor? I've got to make it a sacrifice. If it costs me nothing, there's no honor coming back. Serve until it's no longer considered serving. But love. Serve until it's no longer considered serving, but love. Integrity is the microphone through which a person speaks. Character is the volume in which they hear you. But the reputation of serving is the arena in which the audience will get. So I'm going to say, come see this man. Everything he says, he backs up with his actions. Some are going to say, I believe you because I've seen your actions and not just heard your words. What is your reputation? Does it need to